In this screencast, we're going to look at an example of adiabatic cooling, which is a process by which a cold liquid can be used to cool a hot gas. Specifically, we're going to look at an example of adiabatic humidification of air by the evaporation of cold water. In this example, we have humid air that's at 40 degrees C and 20% relative humidity that enters an adiabatic spray chamber at a specified rate, and the air is adiabatically humidified to 50% relative humidity. So we want to use the humidity charts to find the outlet temperature and the rate the water is evaporating in the spray chamber. A flow chart of the spray chamber is shown below. So here we have our hot air coming in at the specified conditions. We also have cold water coming in that's sprayed into the chamber. And some of these liquid water droplets are going to evaporate. We'll call that rate of evaporation m.h2o. We have water leaving as well, so the difference between the water going in and the water going out must be the rate that water is evaporating. And the evaporation of water has the effect of cooling air on the outlet side. As water evaporates, it's going to humidify the air to 50% relative humidity. Now, the term adiabatic humidification is somewhat contradicting. We're clearly cooling the air as the water evaporates. But if we draw a system boundary between the spray chamber and the surroundings, we can see where the term adiabatic applies. There is no heat exchange between the spray chamber and the surroundings, so Q is equal to zero, which is implied with the term adiabatic. All the heat transfer is between the water and the cool air inside the chamber. So to find the outlet temperature of the humidified air, we'll go to the humidity charts to see how this process works. I've shown a reprint of the humidity charts in SI units. We know the air going into the spray chamber is 40 degrees, and that can be found on the x-axis where the dry bulb temperature is shown. So this is the temperature that would normally measure with a thermometer, and we're at 40 degrees going into the chamber. We also know the relative humidity is 20%, which is along this curve. So the air entering the spray chamber is represented by the intersection of these two points at approximately right here. A coincidence of the air-water system is that adiabatic humidification occurs along lines of constant wet bulb temperature. The lines of constant wet bulb temperature are the diagonal lines that go across the chart. So here we follow our initial condition at 20% relative humidity along the lines of constant wet bulb temperature until we reach the relative humidity of 50%. So the air leaving the spray chamber has a relative humidity of 50% at this point. And if we drop a line down to the temperature scale, we see that the temperature leaving the spray chamber is about 30 degrees. So the temperature of the air entering the spray chamber has been decreased from 40 degrees to 30 degrees at the outlet due to the evaporation of water. So next we'll find the rate the water is evaporating. Here the humidity chart is shown again with our humidification process highlighted. And if we want to know the rate that water is evaporating, we know that that is related to the change in moisture content, which is shown on the y-axis. The change in moisture content is also referred to as the change in the absolute humidity. The rate that water is evaporating is going to be proportional to the change in absolute humidity. If we look at the units here, we see that it's kilograms per kilogram of dry air. In other words, it's kilograms of water per kilogram of dry air. So we need to multiply the change in absolute humidity on a per kilogram of dry air basis by the actual flow rate of dry air that we have. Now we don't know what the flow rate of dry air is. We were given a volumetric flow rate, but there's another quantity on the chart that's going to help us, and that's the humid volume. This is in units of cubic meters of humid air per kilogram of dry air. So by looking at the units, if we want the mass flow rate of dry air, we need to divide the volumetric flow rate by the humid volume. So we need to find the absolute humidity at the inlet and the outlet, as well as the humid volume. We can get the absolute humidity at the inlet by drawing a horizontal line from our initial condition to the y-axis. It's a little bit hard to read. We can see that it's close to 0.009, so I'm going to use a value of 0.0092. And again, that's in units of kilograms of water per kilogram of dry air. We can do the same to find the absolute humidity at the outlet. So drawing a horizontal line from our outlet condition to the y-axis. It's a little bit over 0.013, so I'll use a value of 0.0132. The last thing we need is the humid volume, and specifically we need the humid volume at the inlet condition because that's where we know the volumetric flow rate of humid air that's entering the spray chamber. We know the volumetric flow rate is 100 meters cubed per hour. So if we start at the initial condition and follow the humid volume line, which are the steep diagonal curves, the humid volume is found below the x-axis, and in this case, we're right on the humid volume line of 0.9 meters cubed per kilogram. With the three numbers that we need from the humidity charts, I'll scroll down to calculate the rate of water evaporation. So if we cancel out some of the units here, we see that the volume of humid air cancels out, as well as the mass of dry air. So plugging in these values, we get a calculated rate of evaporation of 0.44